When undergraduates first look at ciliates in the microscope, I always hear, "Ooh!" And you know that they've actually focused on them.
They're great because they're large cells. They're easy to actually look inside and see what's going on. I like the quote from Yogi Berra, you can see a lot just by looking.
They are a complex organism all wrapped up in a single cell. And they're really quite beautiful, I think.
This is a good time for me to introduce my lab mascot, Ted Tetrahymena, here. They have all these ciliate, which allows them to swim around, which is really cool.
Historically, it's been very clear that major discoveries have been made in ciliates. Certainly the self-splicing RNA of Tom Cech and histone modifications, telomerase. They've already really shown their worth.
So, sorry, Ted, I have to turn you inside out. But so what's cool about ciliates, even though they're single cell organisms, is they've actually taken the two essential functions of the chromosomes, those necessary for regulated gene expression and those necessary for propagating the genome to the next generation. They separated that into two functionally different nuclei. Researchers have been able to use that to ask what is the difference between a genome that needs to be propagated versus those that need to express the gene.
My graduate advisor, David Ellis, was using Tetrahymena thermophila in the lab to discover modifications on histone proteins that the DNA wraps around. And these modifications alter the ability of genes to be turned on or off for transcription. This was fascinating to me that you could use a single-celled organism to understand this very complex question.
I really like ciliate's genetic organization. And then if you mate the cells, the amount of genome gymnastics that they go through is just insane.
Roughly 250,000 DNA pieces across the genome in Oxytricha have to be extracted and properly assembled to produce their functional chromosomes. And so this process in Oxytricha is akin to a process of cancer transformation in some cells run backwards. So if we could better understand and even harness the features in Oxytricha that allow it to stabilize this chaos and restore order to a cell, then we would better be able to understand either some of the processes underlying cancer or how to better regulate genome integrity.
We were curious about how it is that chromosomes are maintained. And we discovered this enzyme telomerase in Tetrahymena. And it turns out that it's present in all ciliates and it's present in many different organisms. And then by continuing to ask the question, what is it that telomerase is really essential for? That then led to very important implications in health and disease. And we found out that telomerase is really essential for the growth of cancer cells and that it also plays a major role in age-related degenerative disease.
Genome editing is an extremely popular and exciting field right now, but nature's been doing genome editing for billions of years. In organisms like Oxytricha and other ciliates, they have RNA-guided genome editing systems that occur sometimes with exquisite accuracy, reproducibly occurring generation after generation.
Lately, there's been a term called transgenerational inheritance. Ciliates seem to be able to do this very well. I think ciliates have a lot to tell us in the future.
Some of the benefits of working with ciliates are that you can afford to make mistakes.
With a single-celled organism, you can come in every day and design your experiments and carry them out.
It's relatively inexpensive to do this. So you're doing experiments on the order of weeks rather than months or years.
And getting that kind of a relatively rapid answer is very satisfying, especially to students to kind of suck them in.
The ciliate community is very strongly invested in training the next generation of scientists. They put a lot of time and resources in that direction, and I felt very supported in that way.
The four of us published a paper in PNAS with two undergraduates, and it was a terrific finding. It was great fun. And as I say, that little chromosome ended up being a vehicle for genetic engineering in Tetrahymena.
You can use high copy number RNA vectors to transform the cells with your transgene and end up with 18,000 copies of your transgene, which can really boost protein expression levels.
We have been successful in producing ion channels with Tetrahymena that have never been produced in any other system.
People sometimes ask me the question, well, did you know right away that this was a Nobel Prize winning discovery? And no, I didn't, but I was really excited by it because I knew that it was something new and fundamental.
What we're working on
can result in the development of new drugs that reduce human suffering and make a substantial difference to the world.
It's very important to fund translational research. That is important because we do need new healthcare and new medicines, but you also have to put a lot of effort and funding those fundamental curiosity-driven questions that come out of model organisms, because that's where the really truly new discoveries are going to come from.
Thank you.